And here is the Writer's Almanac for Tuesday, September the 24th, 2019. It's the birthday of Jim Henson in Greenville, Mississippi, 1936, who as a college freshman created a puppet show for a local TV station. And for it, he created the character Kermit the Frog, made him from his mother's pale green coat and a ping pong ball. It was the beginning of the Muppets. It was in 1969. The show on public television, Sesame Street, was starting out, and they asked Jim Henson to join. It's the birthday of the poet Evan Boland, born in Dublin, 1944. She wanted to be a writer, and when she looked at the Irish literary tradition, she found almost no women poets in the ranks. So she set out to be one, writing about motherhood and about life in the suburbs. Evan Boland, who said, "Poetry is one of the most fugitive arts. It can be assigned to memory, taken and hidden in the mind, smuggled into smoky cabin back rooms, recited there, and then conveyed only by speech to another person. It is therefore the most likely to survive colonization." It's the birthday of the man who said the test of a first-rate intelligence is the ability to hold two opposed ideas in the mind at the same time and still retain the ability to function. Francis Scott Fitzgerald, F. Scott Fitzgerald, born in St. Paul, 1896. He went to Princeton. An aunt paid his way there. Tried out for the football team, was cut from the team. He was kicked out of Princeton. He went into the Army. He went to officer training camp in Alabama, made a girlfriend there, Zelda Sayre. He wanted to go off to war, but the war ended before he could get into it. He and Zelda were engaged. She called off the engagement because he didn't have enough money. So he went back to St. Paul, and he wrote a novel, This Side of Paradise, which was a big success. Fitzgerald's daughter Scotty said about Scott and Zelda, "People who live entirely by the fertility of their imaginations are fascinating, brilliant, and often charming, but they should be sat next to at dinner parties, not lived with." And it's the birthday of Blind Lemon Jefferson, born on a farm in Couchman, Texas, around 1893. Picked up the guitar as a teenager, played on the streets, getting change in a tin cup. Made his way to Dallas, then made his way to Chicago, recorded for Paramount Records. He recorded nearly 100 songs over 3 years. He became the first country blues musician with a national following. He was only about 36 years old when he died in Chicago, his body found on a street in a December snowstorm. Buried back in Wortham, Texas, in a grave with a granite marker engraved with his own lyrics, "Lord, it's one kind favor I'll ask of you, see that my grave is kept clean." Here's a poem by Dan Gerber entitled Climate. "In this heat and marathon drought, the seasons have gotten confused. Two tarantulas crossing the road this morning, looking for love as they do this time of year. Although we're actually just into the fall, while the struggling young oak in the yard, which normally breaks its buds in February when it's normally raining, brought out its new leaves just a month ago in early September. How can this be? And what will the tree do now when winter arrives?" Climate. Poem by Dan Gerber from his collection Particles, published by Copper Canyon Press and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.